Hello, it's John Hope Bryant. I'm the founder, chairman, and CEO of Operation Hope, and I've called for a new Marshall Plan. On the back end of COVID-19 and our nation's national civil unrest, it's almost like a 400-year-old colonic, a 400-year delayed expression of frustration by Black America of the slights that have gone unhealed and in many ways even unrecognized. Before I get to the Marshall Plan and why I think it's good for everybody watching this video and those you're going to share it with and hopefully the legislators you're going to communicate with, let me tell you why I think it's necessary and how we got here. Let me say it very, very briefly. Imagine you had a disagreement with your mother-in-law, and you love your mother-in-law, you at least care for her. You are forced in this relationship because of the marriage you have. And so she's with you. She's your family. There's some slight that you deliver to her that was never healed, maybe never even addressed. You never talked about it. You talked past each other. You gave each other church hugs on holidays, not real hugs. You never really embraced. You certainly never dealt with the slight. You never apologized. You never even acknowledged it. So she smiled at you. You smiled at her. You said, hey, how you doing? But of course, in America, unlike other parts of the world, we say, how you doing? And it's a greeting. We don't really want to know how you doing. It's not like, how you doing? And the other person goes, well, you know, I'm not feeling very good. I got my toe ache. My back hurts. And let me tell you about my, you know, Achilles heel. People are like, whoa, whoa, whoa. I was just saying hello. So in this situation, how you doing at the holidays is just really, unfortunately, just a greeting. And so nothing gets addressed. And this goes on for 4 months, maybe 4 years. And then there's something that goes down in the household and you need your mother-in-law's support. It's factual. It's fact-based. It's easy. Your mother flips on you. She goes the opposite direction. She takes the other point of view just because she can. Because she's feeling the slight. I have a way that I try to live my life, talk without being offensive, listen without being defensive, but always leave even your adversary with their dignity. Because if you don't, they'll spend the rest of their life trying to make you miserable. It becomes personal. You win the battle maybe, but you lose the war. This is what happens with the mother-in-law problem. You maybe have won a battle, whatever that was, but you've lost the war. Mother-in-law will get her comeuppance. She will get her revenge. And this just grows over time. It must heal. Three ways to live. Coping, ignoring, and healing. And the coping part may lead to suicide because people at some point just reach a breaking point. So how do we heal a 400-year-old slight? Because that's what happened. And it's the biggest slight you can imagine. It wasn't just an emotional slight or a family tiff. It was economic. It was family. It was human dignity. It was slavery. And how do you heal from something? I think we can, by the way. That's the whole point of this. But how do you heal from something easily where the whole crux of America is you work by your hands, you know, to the bones, and you work your tail off? This is my new book, Up From Nothing, coming out in October. You can pre-order it now on all the platforms. You work your tail off, but the harder you work on that plantation, the larger the man's big house gets. You work your tail off, and he gets a horse and buggy, Mercedes today. You work your tail off, and he gets a room addition. Okay? You work your tail off, and he gets a trail ride for his family. Call that a European vacation today. So it's a reverse transfer of wealth. No wonder Black Americans have an 80% net worth compared to their mainstream counterparts. Or no wonder that the average African American house is worth 40 to 50% less than their mainstream counterparts. Because this legacy of reverse wealth transfer and ingrained systemic indifference or racism and bias was embedded in the system as recently as 1970, where the federal government discriminated against minority neighborhoods by not even ensuring mortgages there. But we can get through this. So you have the slights of 400 years ago. You have the slights of 1865 after the Civil War, where 40 acres and a mule were reversed and given back to the Confederate soldiers. You have the slights of Abraham Lincoln giving the Confederate soldiers a chance to go back in their communities with a pardon, which means they got their horse and their gun and their freedom. And he thought they'd go back and work on the farm. No, they went back and became the sheriff. And 100 years later, you have the Jim Crow laws enforced by corrupt sheriffs and police officers in the South with badges during the day and Klan robes in the evening. And literally local law in direct opposition to federal law, because federal law gave blacks the right to vote and public assembly and access going back to the 1800s. It just wasn't enforced because the president after Lincoln just said, I'm kidding, just kidding, or whatever Lincoln said, and pulled all the federal troops out of the South. And Abraham Lincoln created a Freedmen's Bank to teach free slaves about money, but unfortunately he was killed. So the 40 acres and a mule, which was really only 400,000 acres for 18,000 families, not the 4 million slaves who were enslaved, just 18,000 families. And the majority of those 18,000 families had the Rough Riders with horses and guns. Guess where they got those from? Come in after Lincoln was killed, which was a month after the Freedmen's Bank was put in the law, and took the land back. So 40 acres and a mule, then came the bank. And the next month, Lincoln was killed. That happened in 4 months. So black folks never got the memo on free enterprise and capitalism and economic and ownership and opportunity. My book, The Memo, that's a bestseller. You should pick that up and read it if you have it. It's a primer on the next book that's coming up, Up From Nothing, The Untold Story of How We All Succeed. It's a setup. That's a step, next step from the book before that, How the Poor Can Save Capitalism. And really the book before that, which is a philosophy of love, leadership, of how we need to comport ourselves as brothers and sisters today. But we need more than inspiration and books and direction. And I think we need more even than what I've done at Operation Hope, which is 4 million clients, helped 22 states, 154 locations, $3.5 billion invested over 28 years since the Rodney King riots. All good, but not enough. I thank all the partners that helped us get us here, but not enough. So now we have a Freedmen's Bank building has been renamed in honor of the former slaves who put every dime they had in that bank, but not enough. So now I've called for a new Marshall Plan. I'm gonna get into details on it in subsequent video series in this series. Let me know what you think about this vision. But basically, some of the things are financial literacy for all, education for all. I mean K through college, not K through high school, right? You cannot have a world-class nation where half the population is high school educated. We need jobs for the future, not jobs for the past. All right, jobs for the future, not skills for the past. Right. I'm talking about access to capital for all, access to the banking system for all. I'm talking about a living wage for all. I'll get into the details on this, but I'll put in the link here, the link to the new Marshall Plan published by the Milken Institute. I want you to read this. It goes into great detail on my multi-point plan of how we reset America. And let me know what you think. Spread it, share it, call your legislators, call your mayor, call your city council, call your state assembly. By the way, states can do this, cities can do this, and the federal government should do this, House and Congress signing in the law, bipartisan president making it law. And that should happen in 2020 or 2021, but it needs to happen soon. It's a resetting of everything. And we've been here before because we had the Marshall Plan after World War II. And let me tell you something, America was not a global power before World War II. It's how we behaved after the war. Listen now, after the civil unrest, after COVID-19, because we're at war right now. COVID-19 is a war. It's COVID-19 is trying to rob you of your health and your wealth. That's war, and it ain't playing fair. And it's taking people out. That's war. We're at war with the virus, but we're also in almost civil disobedience with each other. And a house divided cannot stand. That's biblical. So we have to fix this. So after World War II, America supported through the Marshall Plan the rebuilding of the countries that had bombed us. So African Americans have been bombed and brutalized and murdered and killed, but we're going to support those who brutalized us because we're going to do unto others as we want to be done on ourselves. Or as they say in South Africa, Ubuntu. I am me because you are you. Ubuntu, I am me because you are you. Because whatever goes around, comes around. Not because you deserve it, but because I do. That, because that's the way I roll. And so I can't get in your heart and change how you feel about me, but I can get in my heart and change how I feel about you. America rebuilt the nations that had bombed us, Germany and Japan. Who are our biggest allies today? Germany and Japan. Who are our biggest trading partners today? Germany and Japan. It goes on and goes on and goes on. So, and then we pivoted to America and what was called the new Marshall Plan. Sorry, the Marshall Plan and the GI Bill. As much education you can shove down your as your throat to returning vets. So preparing them for the future, college included. A mortgage for a car. For a home, so you can start your wealth creation, right? Because home ownership is the first step of wealth creation for most people. And those two things launched the middle class, right? And an apprenticeship for a job for the future. Those three things launched America for the 20th century and made us a global power, superpower around the world, and gave everybody a refrigerator and a microwave and a car and a vacation home and a vacation and promise and opportunity for all. And we need to do that again, a new Marshall Plan that picks up where that left off and reaches to the least of these God's children and lifts them up. I'll end by quoting Dr. King. This is not a black plan. This is an American plan that includes finally black people. He said, Dr. King, I'm not here to save black people. I'm here to redeem the soul of America from the triple evils of war, racism, and poverty. Let's go. Let me know what you think. Share this video. Watch the subsequent videos as I break the plan now out. And let me know what you think of the new Marshall Plan. It's in the link. Peace and light. And follow the movement at John Hope Bryant and at Operation Hope. Peace and light.